Okay. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening sa inyong tanan diha. No? So today, I will again talk about the law of supply. Okay, the law of supply said that there is a direct relationship between the price of a good and the quantity supplied of that good. So, see, for example, let's just change the color sa color of this. Emphasize. So, say for example, the price goes up to a kwan, price, the good, the quantity supplied will also go up. The price goes down, the QS will also go down. Because normally, if you are the supplier, kung ang iyong presyo taas, normally, daghan imong gusto supply because mas dako ka og kita. Especially if you bought the product much more cheaper than before. For example, if you bought the product, say example, 100 pesos, and then nimahal siya ang presyo from 100 na himo 500, your supply or your QS will increase normally because mahal naman siya. Pero itong butang pabanit na ang yung presyo is 100 before, then gidecrease siya from 100 to 20, normally ang yung QS will go down because you don't want to sell more of this product. Kay gamay ra imo kita ikati mo 100 po biligyan mo 20, you cannot sell that one. It's either zero or lesser than say 100. Okay, so that's how law of supply works. That's why ang iyahang kuan graph normally is upward slope. No? So bali kung dia 100 and G's, and 10 food, dala na food, then dala food siya is 20 sa dana. So, na po, in case ako ng presyo, from 20 to 30, so 30 pa dana. So, as you can see, increasing siya. No? That's the nature of law of supply. The more it's higher price, the more supply na inyong isupply. So, 3% of quantity of good that the seller is willing to offer per se. That's the definition of supply. So how much do you offer for sale if the price is 100? How many you are willing to offer if the price is 50? That's supply. Now let's go over with the supply function. The supply function is just QS is equals to A plus BP. As you can see, it's different from the demand because na A plus because increasing ang presyo, increasing po ba ang QS. So adding it all together. To put into practice ang ato ang supply, same nga po ng A is the value of QS if the price is zero, and B is still the interval in every change in QS and every change in price. Now, let's say for example this example, no, law supply function. We have supply function here, 100 plus 5p, and we have the table here. So let's you pause the video for a while and then answer the table and fill in the blanks. Okay, so answer this one for a few minutes, pause the video and then answer this one. Okay, so how was it? Pila yung answer. So let's try to check if your answer is correct or your answer is wrong. Now, as you can see, anyways, if wrong siya, at least you will learn something. As you can see, na ay given ang QS. Now, let's first go to ang given is ang price. Okay, kaling 60 na ang price na. So, say for example, Yung function is 100. Excuse me. Plus, then just input the p, so 5 times 60. How much is 500 times 60? It's, how much is that? 5 times 60, it's 300. So, 100 plus 300. May pila mo na siya. It will be 400. So, therefore, the answer here is 400. Okay? Correct ba yung answer? Very good. Now, next is we will be solving for the price given ang QS price ang pangitaan. Now, just share to you the function or the formula for getting the P. So, P is equals to QS minus A over D. Okay, so natong formula. So, maori yung sa QD na reverse lang. Pwede po, manumunuhunin nyo. Say, for example, given ang 300. So, 300 at our QS is equals to how much? 100 plus 5P. So, ito yung button is a transpose. So, 300 minus 100 equals 5P. So, pili mo na. 300 minus 1. So, 200 equals 5P. So, cancel out 5, divide 5, so our P is equals to 200 divided by 5, it's 40, so our price is 40, so diyan lugar 40 ang answer, yeah, 40 to our answer diyan. Okay, 40. Let's check using our formula. So, QS, pila itong QS, 300. Minus A, pila ang A, 100. Over B, interval, which is 5. 300 minus, 300 minus 200, divided by 5. Divided by 5 equals to how much? 40 gapon. So, take an answer. Okay. So, how about this one? 500. So, simple na no? 500 minus 100. 500 minus 100. 500 minus 100 is 400 divided by 5. Pinaman, 400 divided by 5. So, 80. So, karo ng answer niya is 80. Okay. How about this one? 60. 600. 600 minus 100 is 500 divided by 5. It's 100. Okay. So, correct ba ito yung mga answer? Hopefully, correct yung mga answer. Okay, so that's how, what supply function works. So, meron na siya. So, you can go back to this video again if you're confused. Go back, rewind the video para masabtan ninyo. Okay? So, now let's proceed to the shifters of supply. Now, these are the shifters of supply now. So, price of resources, number of producers, technology, taxes, and subsidies, and expectation. These are the non-price determinants when it comes to the supply curve. Therefore, ang price of resources, kung ang nagmahal ang consumer itong produkto, nagmahal ang price sa, say, baboy. So, kung namahal ang price sa baboy, therefore, mas less ang inyong masupply ng shumai because mas mahal man siya pag-produce. Gets ninyo? Number two, number of producers. Kung ang number of producers ni gamay o ni daghan, po gidaghan ang producers, therefore, sa hindi yung change ang presyo, nadaghan nga po ng supply. Example, itong time sa pandemic, may pagkaya ka supply o face mask. Kalaunan, nagdaghan na ang supplier. So, nagdaghan na ang supply. Ang price, wala pa nag-change. So, daghan na ang supply. Next is technology. So, technology can also help with the production of product. Kung mas paspas na karang technology, mas minapaspas ang technology, mas daghan ang mahimo. The price still stay the same. Now, taxes and subsidies can also be one of the non-price determinants. No? Taxes and subsidies. Taxes is kanang gendugang sa tax sa mga company. For example, like tax, income tax, something like that. Subsidies are somehow the way the government help the producer. So, kung kulang ang production sa rice, para tabangan ang production sa rice, maghatag sila subsidies sa mga farmers para magmulagan ng rice. Then, sa taxes, tulip ang taxes, kung magmuwala ang taxes, mudaghan ko lang yung supply. For example, ang tax sa una is 25%. Karong naghihinag, na isa ka resolution nga, nag-ingon nga, ang tax na lang is 5%. So therefore, mas less ang imong gasto sa paghimo sa product, kay less naman ang tax. Therefore, mas nadaghan ang imuhang ma-supply nga produkto. Subsidy sa isang lugar, gahimo mo og sa example, face mask na kinahanglan kayo mo na face mask din kay ang time, pandemic siya. So, the government will give subsidy to the manufacturers of face mask to produce more face mask even though the price will not change. And then expectation. So, normally, na expectation, for example, ikaw maligyan kag lugit. Normally, ang price sa lugit, masaka mo, boss man. Ikaw, seller ka sa lugit. Now, if the price karon is 45, pero ugma mo 65 siya, tapos ama, what will happen to the demand nimo sa demand nimo sa kuan? Sa supply nimo sa lugit karon. So, ugma, umahal man siya ugma, therefore, less na yung supply karon ng lugit sa mabaligya ang lugit, magulat ka, pagkaugma, ay hindi ka mag-supply ang daghan because it's much more expensive or mas taas ang presyo ugma kaysa karon mas daong kita ugma kaysa karon. Yes, that's how the supply curve works. No? So, same gyapon, ito yung graph siya, no? Ito ka na, going up gyapon siya. Sample 30 lang yapon itong price niya. Sample 10. So even though the price will not change, sample nagmahal ang baboy, so it's a decrease of supply, so inward shift siya. Nangyari karon na lagi shift siya inward pagulong diha. Therefore, ang base na 30 ang sa una gisra ang imong supply na ng karon is say 5. And inward man shift. How about the outward shift, sir? Outward shift at the bottom ng sample. So outward shift siya, so nag-increase siya. So sa una 30 gisra karon nahimo na siya og say 25. Okay. So as you can see, ang price did not change, only the quantity demanded. Okay? Kung inward gani, again, pag inward gani, it's decreasing. Pag outward, it's increasing. Okay? So, more na siya about the shifters of supply. Again, price does not shift the curve. Price only moves along the curve. May change sa price gani, change, decrease or increase sa price, ang iyang movement is along the curve lang. Pero pag naay shifters involved, like price of resources, nag-increase ang price sa baboy, nag-increase ang price sa resources, nag-daghan ang producers, na-improve ang technology, nakuha ng tax, nag-subsidy, mamahal ugma, mabarato ugma, it's about shifters. So ang iyang movement shift along, shift out, inward or outward na yan siya. Okay? So I hope klaro na siya. Okay. So if you have some confusion, just rewind the video for you to remember, understand a little bit what the discussion. Okay? So thank you everyone. Goodbye and God bless.